this is Maritza Ortega.
Mari J. Perez.
And we are talking about decluttering your life. And we have discussed how clutter affects four different areas of our life. Mari, can you tell us a little bit about those four areas?
Yes, friends, of course. We produce results in four areas. The first area is health and well-being. The second area is our occupational profession and creative endeavors. The third area will be relationships. And the fourth and last area will be our use of time and our financial freedom.
So today we are going to cover the area of happiness and well-being. Mari, can you explain the definition of well-being?
Well-being is a sense of happiness and contentment with our life. And it encompasses, in a holistic way, our mind, our body, and I would say our spiritual connection as well. And I wanted to ask, Maritza, as a home stager, when you come to a home that someone wants to sell their home and they come and contract you for that, and then you come to that home and you see all that clutter around and you know it's gonna be a lot of work ahead, what happens there and how do you deal with that?
Clutter plays a huge role when it comes to selling a house. And not only in the buyer, this prospective buyer, but also in the seller. First of all, I want to talk about the buyer. The buyer will not come to a house or will not find that well-being in a house that feels or looks cluttered. We buy because of an emotional connection. And if I don't find that connection, that's not going to be appealing to me. But also it affects the well-being and happiness of the seller because it causes stress. Mm-hmm. Selling a house, first of all, is an emotional process. Mm-hmm. It can be very stressful. Just the selling process can be stressful. Now imagine having all that clutter.
Yeah.
One of the recommendations I make is to remove the clutter. Less is more. So they start feeling that stress and that anxiety about having to declutter their home after living there 20 years sometimes. Can you imagine all the things that they have accumulated over those years?
Yeah.
It can create a lot of stress and unhappiness, frustration, mm-hmm. when it comes to selling the house. So it definitely, the clutter definitely affects the buyer and the seller. So one of the things that I recommend when it comes to decluttering their life, their home, is to take one room at a time, because it can be very overwhelming. So working towards one area at a time. And number two is to think about the things that you own. Are they things that you like, need, or use? You have asked yourself those three questions and the answer is no. Go ahead and find a new home for them. So if you don't like it, need it, or use it, go ahead and eliminate that. Now, the number three is that I will also support Marie Kondo's philosophy in saying, if it doesn't spark joy, go ahead and eliminate it. However, I am going to say that this is not always easy for the homeowner or the seller. Sometimes we have this attachment to things and it's not very easy to say, okay, I'm just going to let it go. So in your experience as a career and life coach, Mari, how do you recommend they approach this process?
First is to acknowledge that change is difficult. We know that change is everywhere, but we seem to resist it anyway. And I like the idea that you suggest your clients to think about their vision. If they're excited about, they're selling their home because they're moving to another place, bigger, or they're moving, relocating because better job opportunities, think about that and get excited about it. And then once you make a decision that it will have to take place before I get to my goal, then I'm gonna have a better attitude. One of the things that creates a lot of, moves against well-being and creates a lot of trouble for us is our thinking patterns. And I call it mental clutter. When we have predominant thoughts are negative during the day, our thoughts impact the way we feel, and the way we feel impact our emotions, impact our results. So I recommend the three C's, and the three C's is no complain, no criticism, and no comparison. And I asked them, well, start small, only for 24 hours, only for today. Just you say to yourself, today I'm gonna practice the three C's, and I'm going to be complaint free, comparison free, and complaining free. And I'm not gonna criticize myself or others. And then at the end of the day, you're gonna find that you're gonna feel much better. So the way we think and the way we perceive our reality impacts the way we feel. And that's one of the recommendations that I give.
And it's funny that you say that, because it can be a difficult process. And one of the first reactions I see in my clients is like, oh, it's going to take me so long, or it's going to be so hard. And I encourage them to think about the end. Remember, what is our goal? And our goal at the end of the day is to be able to move into the next chapter of our life. And that's exciting. So why don't we start clean? Why don't we start fresh? Why don't we only bring things that we care about, that we're going to use in our new house, and that's going to open up the possibilities as well.
Yeah. That's interesting. And Marisa, I wanted to ask you, what happened to your clients after you have walked the journey with them to declutter their homes, and they stage everything to make that home appealing to a potential buyer? What happened to your homeowners when they are in that situation?
I love this question. Well, the way in which the clutter or removing the clutter affects their well-being is, again, number one, thinking about the buyer. The buyer is going to be more attracted to that home because it feels light, spacious, inviting, and they're going to want to buy it. That's going to bring joy and happiness to the seller because we're achieving our goal. But number two, it affects the homeowner, the seller, because after they have seen what they have done, it feels so much lighter. It feels harmonious. It feels peaceful. It feels inviting, a place where you can find comfort and joy, that they want to stay. They fall in love with the house all over again, and they say, maybe I should stay. Of course, they remember that their goal is to move. And again, it brings joy, happiness, and that feeling of success or achieving that goal, because then we can move into the next home. It's a win-win situation for everybody. It's just the process is difficult, but at the end, everybody feels good about it.
And I think the before and after illustrate the impact of clutter in our health. When we feel in a space that is constricted, that we don't have a space, is stressed out, we want to sometimes overeat and even eat snacks that are unhealthy.
And sometimes we don't even want to be there. We don't find it comforting and we want to avoid being in there. And one other thing that I've noticed, we feel ashamed of that space. We don't want to invite friends, we don't want to bring family, but when it feels so much lighter, we want everyone to see what we have done. We feel excited about it. So it does, again, it brings us back to how clutter affects our well-being.
And the homes is supposed to be a place where you come at the end of the day to rest, to feel relaxed.
To find peace,
to gather yourself and the ones you love. And if you don't create an environment that is harmonious and produce that sense of feeling of peace, then your home is really not representing a lifestyle of well-being and happiness.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and continue joining us. Continue learning and growing with us, because we love bringing you this content, these materials on how to declutter your life and how that has an impact, a positive impact on all of us.
And next week, friends, we're going to be talking about productivity, how clutter impacts our productivity and our creative thinking, and what some ideas we can do to declutter so we can be more productive and more creative.
So exciting. I look forward to next week, Maddie.
Next week.
Thank you.
Until next week. Bye.